A Man is 10 Feet Tall by Robert Allen Arthur.
I'm looking for a guy named Lloyd Mills. Inside.
Lloyd Mills?
That's me.
Ed Fabrizio sent me. Said you'd give me a job.
Sit down. You want coffee?
Just a job.
What name you want me to write down?
North. Axel North.
How's Ed?
Okay, last time I saw him.
When was that?
Month, 6 weeks.
Where?
Look, does it make any difference where?
Not really.
It was Frisco.
Go across to 419, ask for a guy named Frank Brill. He's a fat guy standing around all the time. You're a helper.
How much?
The book says a buck and a quarter. You get a buck.
You get a quarter.
Show me your social security and I'll let you have a whole buck and a quarter an hour.
Buck's fine. Can I bartend until payday?
Okay. I get back 12 on payday.
I'd like about, you know, to change. I want to make a phone call.
Yeah? Change.
What color his discharge papers are?
8 to 5 says there aren't any discharge papers.
No bet.
Long distance.
Operator, I want to make a person-to-person call to Minneapolis. I want to speak to Miss Catherine Sundstrom. The number there is Gramercy 3. No, number there is Quincy 30420. Number here is Gramercy.
One moment, please. Yes, what is your number?
Number here is Gramercy 94869. I'll hold that.
Thank you, sir. Hello, Quincy 30420?
Yeah?
Miss Catherine Sundstrom, please.
Where's this call coming from?
New York is calling. Are you Miss Sundstrom?
No.
Is she there?
Just a moment.
$2.55, sir.
This time it's New York. Find out if it's him and tell him not to do this anymore.
Mother, please. Hello?
Miss Catherine Sundstrom?
Yes.
Go ahead, please.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello, little baby.
Hello, who's there?
Hello, Catherine. My little baby.
Hello? Hello, who's there?
please?
No one answers, operator. There's no one there.
But the line is open,
Miss. But no one answers.
Please, where is this call coming from?
New York.
Operator, this has happened before. 3 times this month. From San Francisco and Denver and St. Louis. And no one ever answers.
Axel? Is it you, Axel? Oh, please, say something.
I'm saying something, baby. Can't you hear me, baby? I'm talking to you.
Disconnected, miss. I'll check and call you.
Now. No, you got the wrong number, lady. Nobody here called Minneapolis. No.
Here,
and
the white over here. Malik.
Yeah.
Here's your helper.
You. Do like he says, huh?
Hey, man, what am I going to get a helper?
I didn't think you needed one, hotshot.
Uh-oh. Hey, you know you can be the luckiest guy in the world. And everybody can be Charlie Malik's helper. Ain't that right, Charlie?
All right, let's see. Mr. Williams, automotive lot. 6 pieces.
You're retiring already, Charlie?
Do I get them from over in there?
Well, where else, stupid?
Now, wait a minute.
Wait a minute what? Working for me, you do what I say, understand?
Well, you can ask me nice.
That's very funny. All right, I'll ask you nice. Williams Automotive Lot, 6 pieces. Okay? Come on, move, stupid.
Hey, man, you strain yourself. That's no way to... Don't you know how to live?
Thought I did.
It's in the back, Daddy-O. It's all in the back. You use your legs like that and you'll bust wide open. Use the top of your thighs as a lever only. Haven't you got a hook?
No.
Oh, man, you gotta have a hook. See? Simple.
Get me a hook on payday.
You won't last that long.
Alas.
Okay, we got 5 more pieces. You can't take all day. Now listen, stay away from him. Understand? Well, keep moving, stupid. Let's go.
Look beat. How'd you like some soup? Hot, man. Give you that strength. You okay?
Yeah.
Hey, we never introduced ourselves. I'm Tommy Tyler. Everybody calls me TT. Tommy Tyler, TT. Jake, what's your name?
Axel North.
Axel? Axel Grease. Grease Job. Anybody ever call you Grease Job? Hey, where you from? Oh, man, I ask a lot of questions, don't I?
Yeah.
And you don't answer them, do you?
No.
Well, I keep asking them. You know why? I'll tell you. Actually, I'm not what I seem. I mean, you think I was just a guy trying to make a living, won't you? Well, it ain't so. I'm a rich millionaire doing this for kicks. Yeah, I own from 23rd Street all the way down the canal. I just do this to spy on the help. You see, last year I only made $4 billion profit, and I got a figure to make me 6. So I got to find out who's stealing from me, dig? Hey, man, you can laugh. I thought I was too tired to laugh.
Ah, you gotta laugh. You take that, Charlie. With a crumb like that, you're either gotta laugh at him or beat his brains out. That's the lowest form of animal life. You either gotta laugh at it or stomp on it.
I don't know.
You let him know who's boss and he's easy. Maybe you'll have to fight him first, but after that, he's yours.
I was thinking maybe I'd get myself another job.
He doesn't scare you, does he?
No. I just don't want to fight him.
What are you, a religionist or something? I mean, I got a cousin, and his religion tells him he mustn't fight. You know, a guy could walk into his house and wipe out his wife and kids, and he wouldn't raise a hand? Is that the way you are?
I don't have any wife or kids. Just me. I can always get another job.
Oh, boy, I got a wife and kids. Two kids. Yes, sir. A girl 3 years old and a baby boy 6 months. You know, you sure picked a funny place to work if you don't want to fight.
Why?
You ever dig the lower forms of animal life, man? I do, all the time. You lay out on the ground sometimes in the summer and look down at the ants. Oh, it's crazy. They work and they fight. They work and they... I was reading in the paper the other day. There's been 73 unsolved murders on this waterfront in the last 10 years.
73?
All unsolved. That's a joke, eh? You take the Charlie. He's an ant. Oh, he's a butcher ant. I seen him kill one guy myself already. And there's been more.
How does he get away with it?
Who cares? 73 bums, you know, floaters. Who cares? Nobody cares, nobody talks.
Maybe you care.
I don't know. Maybe some of them 73 guys are on my side, huh? Maybe some are working for me, huh? Well, the thing is, sometimes a man's got to make a choice.
Why?
Because that's the way she goes, man. Look, there are the men, and then there are the lower forms, you know? The guy's got to make a choice. You go with the men and you're 10 feet tall. You go with the lower forms and you're down in a slime.
What if you just don't want to go with anybody?
Then you're alone, man. And that's the worst. Hey, this is getting morbid. Let me buy you a piece of pie.
No,
I insist. You may not know it, Daddy-O, but you were the last of the big spenders. Huckleberry or apple?
Huckleberry.
All righty. Hey, boy, them Yankees sure laid down on you today, didn't they, huh?
We watch tomorrow, boy.
You having a nice lunch, Charlie? Hey, yeah. What? Just a lousy piece of pie.
No, I don't mean for a pie. I mean for letting me in on your little confidence. It's your own appears. I appreciate knowing that secret.
Just don't let it get around, huh? Oh, boy.
Okay, go ahead, take it. Let's go, kid. Come on, let's go. Come on. Now get another truck, will you?
Hey, Charlie. Why don't you take it easy with the kid?
Why don't you mind your own business?
You know, Charlie, in spite of your miserable, unpleasant exterior, I really believe there beats beneath there the blackest heart in town.
Very funny.
But I forgive you. You know why? You're ignorant.
Is that so?
Yeah, you hate because you're ignorant. I feel sorry for you, and so I forgive you.
Is that right? Well, I got news for you. You don't have to forgive me for nothing.
You know what the trouble is with a guy like you, Charlie?
Oh, what's the trouble with a guy like me?
You're a little frightened, grasping man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you close your eyes and you hate.
Is that so?
Yeah, and like everybody in the world who hates you, afraid somebody's gonna take something away from you.
Is that so?
Yeah, well, I got news for you, Daddy. You can relax, because you ain't got nothing I want. You do?
Yeah, you're pretty smart, aren't you?
He's a trust you, Tommy.
Thanks. Wait, what are you doing? You're working for me, not for him.
What's the difference?
The difference is because I say so, that's the difference. Understand that? You hear me? See you turn on 9 o'clock in the morning. Sharp.
Now I'd say he was a hard man to get along with, now wouldn't you? You gonna be here tomorrow?
Here.
ain't much, but it's a bargain at $5 a week. You get hot water 6 to 8 in the morning, 6 to 8 at night. Subway's 2 blocks away. And I change the sheets every other Thursday. Take it or leave it. I can always rent it if I want.
Yeah, I'll take it.
$5 in advance. I don't stand for no lady visitors past midnight.
What's the night rate for a person to call in Minneapolis?
$2.25 for the first 3 minutes, sir.
Thanks, sir. Thanks. I don't think I'll make the call right now. Pretty little baby.
Today.
See, I didn't think I was going to make it myself. I hate to say that.
Well, a couple of 3 days, you'll be over that. Hey, yeah.
What's that for?
Oh, it's an old one I had. I dug it up at home. You can have it.
I'll buy it off you. Only I don't have the money right now.
Don't worry about it. Here. Now, listen, I did something else too, man. Hope you don't mind. See, that checker, you know, he owes me a couple of favors, and I was talking to him this morning. And, well, you can be my helper if you want. Hey, Charlie.
All right, let's cut the chowder and get some
work. I was just
done,
telling Axel he could be my helper if he wants.
What are you talking about?
Ask Brill. It's okay with him.
He's working for me.
Well, let's ask Axel.
You don't have to ask him nothing. He's working for me. Come here, kid. I want to talk to you.
You still got a choice, Axel.
I'm going to give you a friendly little tip. You stay away from him. You know what I mean? You're working for me, understand? If you don't like him, get off the pier. Right now, you're working for me.
What's the difference who I work for, Tom?
Oh, it makes a lot of difference, Stole Charlie here. First off, every hour you work, he puts down an extra dime. Oh, but more than that, we hold different opinions on a lot of things, old Charlie and I do. You know, like unions, a lot of jazz like that there. Oh, it makes a lot of difference, Stole.
All right, just let's knock it off, huh? You're working for me, kid. Let's get started.
I'm working for Tommy.
Charlie, you just do very, very much. Hey, let's take a break, man. We could get run off this pier for working so hard. You coming up to my house tonight? My old lady says I got a call and let her know.
You really want me to come up, Tommy?
No, man. I don't want you to come to the house. I just ask you because I don't want you. You know, I'd hate for you to come to the house.
Well, you know what I mean, see? Yeah, sure, I'd love to come. One of those 42nd Street movies, I'll go right out of my head.
Red beans and rice. Man, once you taste Lucy's red beans and rice, you'll never leave. I'm taking a big chance, Daddy-O.
You know, I'm from Minneapolis.
Yeah? That's nice, Tom.
Yeah, it's all right. My name isn't really North, it's Nordman. Alex Nordman.
I think I like North better. It's more American. And these days, it pays to be 110% American.
Just wanted you to know.
Gee, look at that baby out there. Hey, that's a friendship.
Ah. Parlez-vous français, s'il vous plaît. Next stop, Le Havre. Like to be on board?
Oh, I am on board, man. I'm promenading the deck and digging all that fancy jive like mad. Oh, it's crazy. Oh, it's wild. Now I'm on the top deck. And I'm 600 miles out to sea. And I'm smelling that air, man. It's crazy. You smell it, man?
Smell of garbage in a river.
You would, you know?
That's why I smell, Pete.
Why do you always have to look down, man? Why don't you look up? It's beautiful up there. You're 10 feet tall, so use it to look up.
I'm 6'1".
You know, if everybody was like you, that cat Darwin would never have written a book. In fact, if everybody was like you, there wouldn't be anybody. Everybody would still be swimming around like in slime. Remember, Daddy, it only took one little crazy-celled amoeba who dug he was 10 feet tall. He looked up, he climbed out, and started this whole wild bit.
Just take a look at Charlie, T, and tell me it was worth
it. Oh, man, I never look at Charlie. Well, like, maybe I look at him, but I don't see him. See my wife, Lucy, and red beans and rice, my two kids. You know, like, in my life, Charlie ain't that much.
My life, it's all Charlie. I mean it, T. People always making demands on you. People always making you do things that... My old man, he was a Charlie. The sergeant in the army, he was a Charlie.
So, two guys, what can they do to you?
Not just two guys, T, but everybody. What is it, T? You say look up. Look up because you're 10 feet tall. But how do you get to feel 10 feet tall, T? What's the difference between you and me? You think I like to look down? You think I like smelling the garbage in the river and going out of my head in 42nd Street movies? Last night, I walked the streets of this city, T. I've been in a lot of big cities in the last couple of months, and I walked the streets of them all. Last night, I walked from 42nd Street up to 96th Street, and 5th Avenue, and all the way down again on Park Avenue. All them side streets, T. All them houses and people with places to go and belong. But me, I walk the streets.
Man, just don't go feeling sorry for yourself. Like nobody's doing it to you.
Ain't they, T? Ain't they?
No, man. You see, like, I figure a man only does it to himself.
You guys gonna sit here all day?
Look, man. Maybe the first thing you better do is settle with Charlie. Like, maybe that's the first thing, man. Baby, let's make this with me and you.
Come on, let's make this you and me.
Hey! Handsome cat like me ask an old ugly chick like you to dance. You can't afford to turn him down. Might be your last chance. Come on. Hey, Axel. Would you believe that this old ugly chick and me used to win contests up at the track?
What's that?
The boy ballroom, man. Every Sunday and Thursday. What's that? Didn't I tell you it was the biggest square in town?
I bet if you had a girl here, he could show you a thing or two, old man. Couldn't you, Jack?
Yeah, I guess we could. You don't move so good, Pete.
Put down by my old lady and slandered by my best friend. That does it. You go join the ladies, old lady.
I'll do the dishes.
While the men retire to the drawing room, brandy and cigars. There you go, buddy. Now, don't tell me this ain't brandy, you know? Don't tell me it's 98-cent blueberry wine. Because it is.
'20-year-old brandy.
Now you're getting with it, man.
You
If you missed those 42nd Street movies, we could always turn on the television.
No, no thanks.
Now, we could look at Henry Morgan. He's pretty good.
The guy's good enough. This is a wonderful Corona, Corona.
Corona. Three Coronas.
Corona, 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 Corona.
Oh, boy.
What are you looking at?
I'm just measuring you. You're about at 7.5 feet tall now, with 2.5 to go.
Is it that easy, Tom?
Didn't I tell you? I'll get him loose. Of course, you know it's your turn.
Oh, you want to do the dishes?
No, it's my turn.
Dishes. I just stacked them. What I hate being a woman is that whenever the talk gets interesting, the woman has to go into a kitchen where she can't hear anything. Someday I'm gonna have a house where the kitchen is right in the living room. Like one of those modern glass houses, you know?
Did you ever get it?
Why not? Everything's possible.
Yeah, yes it is. Talk wasn't all that interesting, though. Red beans and rice were good, though. Tommy says you're the best cook in town. I believe him.
I'm from New Orleans, honey, and in New Orleans, the girl gets her Ph.D. in red beans and rice. Say, you ever been there?
Yeah, I was there once. Only I didn't eat any red beans and rice. I didn't eat much of anything.
Bottle fell out of the crib.
That's the hungriest baby in 14 states. Can I do anything for you, Axel?
No, I'm fine.
You got a girl, Axel?
Well, that's what I like about a woman. She comes right out and asks the questions.
What's a natural question?
Would he be sitting here wasting time with us if he had a girl?
Yeah, I would, because I do have a girl.
Yeah, what's her name?
Now who's asking the questions?
It's a natural question.
Name's Catherine. She's 21 years old, very pretty. She's from Minneapolis, too.
She blonde?
Yeah, sort of.
Blue eyes?
Well, gee, I don't know. It's funny, I don't know, see?
Uh-oh, there he is. My turn.
You bet.
You bet.
Oh. Get out of that kitchen and let loose. Get out of that kitchen and let loose.
I gotta go.
Go?
Go where? Don't ask me to explain. I can't. I just gotta get out of here.
Hey.
Take it easy. Sit down.
Leave me alone. Don't you see? I can't stand it here anymore. You've got so much.
What are you talking about?
Tommy, you're right. He sure is the hungriest baby. He's polished off that one, and now he wants another.
See what I mean, T?
What do you mean? What are you talking about? I got so much. What have I got?
Everything.
Oh, man, open your eyes and look around. What have I got? Nothing. Nothing. Well, what, cheap broken-down furniture? Huh? This $25 a month five-flight walk-up?
That's not what I mean, T.
Listen, I wanted to be a musician. Yeah, I wanted to go to Juilliard. Funny? I even thought of being a doctor. I considered being a lawyer. Funny? Huh?
Now, that's not what I'm talking about. See, look, I gotta tell you.
You think I'm crazy, don't you? You think I live in a dream world with 25-year-old brandy and 3 Corona cigars, and I take rides on French ships to La Havre, huh? Well, why not? You think I just want to believe I'm 10 feet tall. Man, I am 10 feet tall. That's faith. Faith, man, and without faith, you are dead. Dead.
Don't tell me the talk isn't interesting now. I'll be right back.
Faith and something else.
That's right. That's right. That's why I don't care if I never make Juilliard. That's why I don't care if I never become a doctor or a lawyer. And man, I don't care if the furniture is broken down. And I don't count the stairs anymore. Man, I fly up those stairs every night. That's all. You ask me today, what's the difference between you and me? I'll tell you. I don't have to walk the streets in no city. I got a woman who loves me. And I got kids who love me. And I don't have to walk the streets in no city.
Tommy, I gotta tell you something. You probably won't like me very much anymore after I tell you this.
You couldn't say anything that'll make me not like you, so don't bother to try. Axel. Why don't you go back to Minneapolis and find out what color eyes that gal's got? I
can't.
Why not? All you gotta do is say, I love you. Man, that's all the average chick wants to hear. You say, I love you, and you're home.
I didn't say that to anybody. I couldn't say that.
Why not? It's the easiest. And man, if you happen to mean it, it's the greatest.
I wanted to say it. But maybe she wouldn't love me.
That's what you're scared of. So what's to be scared? Just play it cool, man.
I don't know how many times I wanted to tell her. I you know what I do, T? Every once in a while, I call her up on the telephone. Every once in a while, when I can't stand it any longer, I just call her up.
Well, that's fine. What's the matter with that?
I'll tell you what's the matter with it. I don't talk to her. I just call her up just to hear her answer, just to hear her voice, and then I hang up without saying a word. I'm a bad guy, T. I don't want to get anybody in any trouble. I don't want to get you in any trouble. I could get you into trouble just by being here.
Any kind of trouble like that I can handle.
Don't, Tommy, look, you don't understand. Listen, about a year ago, I went into the Army. I enlisted. You know what I mean? I just never did anything that good in my life. I thought that maybe once I got to be sergeant, then I could go to captain. You see, a man's got to do something in his life before somebody can love him.
No, man, you're wrong.
I'm not wrong. I learned that from my old man. He was a cop. He was a good cop, too. He was rough. But the thing is, you got to prove yourself first, and then you
No,
can...
man, you're wrong.
I'm not wrong. I'm telling you, T. But in the Army, same as everywhere else. And so I busted out. You hear me, T? I busted out. I deserted, T.
Tommy?
Honey, will you fix some coffee, please?
Sure, I'll fix some.
Tommy, you shouldn't want me to stay here for coffee. You shouldn't want me to be here at all.
Why not?
Told you, T, I'm a bad guy.
No, you're not, Axel. You're my friend.
By this time, Gino is just furious. And he comes in on him, and he's holding two great big six guns and a carbine and a hunting knife about this long. And...
Finish the joke.
It wouldn't be funny now.
Finish the joke.
So he says, well, I'll shoot him, I'll kill him, I'll hang him up from the highest tree. But first, if you don't mind, I'll sing a little song.
That's funny!
No, it isn't.
But why do you always let the Charlies of the world ruin your good time? I'll get a truck. Charlie, why don't you lay off that kid, huh? It really's got nothing to do with that kid, has it? It's me you're after, isn't it? Huh?
All right, out of my way, boy.
I'm not in your way, Charlie. That's the trouble with you. You think I'm in your way. Why don't you look up, Charlie? I'm human like everybody else. Why don't you try to be?
You stink.
Phillips Woolen Mill, 6 pieces.
My truck.
I got it.
Get another one.
Put mine back on.
Make me.
I'll make you.
Come on. Come on.
Hey, isn't this crazy? On a nice day like this, you want to fight? Yeah, Charlie, I thought I dug you, but you're even more ignorant than I realized. And you simmer down now, Axel. You don't want to hurt Charlie. He's too precious. You know, like we're going to preserve Charlie so the future school kids can study him like the dinosaur. Maybe he'll be the last of his species. Come on.
Hey, Tyler.
Get away, Axel.
No.
I said get away.
It's my fight, Tommy.
No, it isn't. It's me he wants. You've been waiting for this for a long time, Huncho.
That's right.
Well, you want to sling hooks around?
Yeah.
You pick on somebody who knows how.
I was a bad guy, Tommy. I ran away once too often.
It was my fault all the time. Oh, Axel.
Sneaking a smoke and
wash my hands, something like
that. Anything, huh? You worked maybe 20 feet away from where it happened. How could you miss it?
Well, I told you, I must have been sneaking a smoke or washing my hands, something like that.
You wash your hands often?
Oh, yeah. 10, 15 times a day. I'm very clean.
So you just don't know anything?
My guess is he slipped and fell. You know what I mean?
Yeah, sure. All right, beat it. We're not through with you, understand?
I'm a law-abiding citizen, officer. I want to see justice
done. Yeah, yeah, sure you do.
Next.
Now, wait a minute. I want to say something to all of you. Whatever happens on this waterfront is your responsibility. You let hoods run this racket, and you pay the penalty. Now, we can't do anything unless you level with us. Nobody can do anything. Well, except maybe die like that guy this morning. You understand that? Only you can stop it. And you can stop it easy, if you want. All right, next. Hello, what's your name?
Wally, Joe Wally.
Is it a fight?
What fight?
Oh, are you washing your hands, too?
No, I think I was sneaking a smoke. My guess is the guy fell down. I really don't know nothing, officer.
How long have you been out with Doc's wash?
She don't know nothing either. Your guess is the guy fell down. Huh? I know all about you, Nordman. Lloyd Mills told me. Now you get 20 years. Odd labor for deserting.
And you were...
You ever been in a pen, Norman?
No.
I have. Murder.
How did Mills find out about it?
Well, listen. Yeah, Fabrizio sent you, didn't he? Well, Mills checks on all his boys. And the information comes in handy.
Shut up over there.
20 years, Norman. Hard labor.
No talking over there.
All right, all right. Beat it, but don't go too far. You can come with me off.
Yeah.
Next. All right, what's your name?
Axel North.
And now, what's your story?
Guess I fell down.
Get out of here. Beat it. Next.
Oh, Charlie Malik. Well, it's like the man says. You know, the guy must have fallen down.
Person to person, Miss Catherine.
Hello?
Miss Catherine Sundstrom?
Yes?
One moment, please. New York is calling.
New York?
$2.55 for the first 3 minutes, sir.
Who is it? Mother, please, go back to bed.
Go ahead, please.
Hello? Hello?
It's me, Catherine.
Oh, Axel, is it you?
Yes.
Mother, please. You called all those other times, too, didn't you? Oh, why, Axel, why wouldn't you talk to me? I've been so worried, so frightened.
Have you, Catherine?
Of course I have.
Catherine, I want to tell you something. I'm a bad guy, Catherine. I'm a deserter from the army. I'm in trouble.
I know.
But that's not what I wanted to tell you, Catherine. I love you, Catherine.
Oh.
Look, don't say anything. Go ahead and hang up if you want. I wouldn't blame you if you did. But I just had to say it. You see, I have a friend who... I had a friend. You really would have liked this guy, Catherine. He told me that I had to tell you that I love you.
Oh, Axel, I love you. Please, my darling. Please come home to me. I don't care what you've done. It doesn't matter. I love you. Whatever it is, we'll work it out somehow. We'll do something, only...
Please, Axel, just come home to me.
Yeah, I'm coming. I'm coming home, baby. I'm coming home, Catherine.
Hurry, Axel. I love you.
Bye, Catherine. Bye, little baby.
North. I was looking for you this morning.
Yeah,
you're late.
Matter of fact, I wanted to talk to you, Mr. Mills.
Well, come on in. Sit down. You want some coffee?
Yes, sir. Thank you. I think I will.
Yeah.
The reason I was late this morning is I had to go uptown to see a friend. Mrs. Tyler.
Who?
Mrs. Tyler, you know. Tommy's wife. He's a fella had the accident yesterday. You know, he fell on his hook.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sure.
Well, I just wanted to give her a little money. I didn't have much, but I gave her what I could.
You didn't have to do that. The welfare fund takes care of things like that. Also, we passed the hat, you know, for funeral expenses.
How much did we collect?
Huh? How much for Tyler's funeral expenses?
Oh, yeah. 120, 125 maybe.
Good. Yeah. How much did you give her?
$42.
We'll reimburse you. Give him the money.
No, thanks. I wouldn't want to have to pay back 52 on payday.
Now, come on.
Oh, no, really. I'd just as soon not take it.
Okay. Be a Rockefeller Foundation if it makes you happy.
Say, you told Charlie I was a deserter from the Army, didn't you?
Did I?
Yeah, so he said.
Then I must have told him.
Gee, I guess information like that keeps a guy like me in line, doesn't it?
It keeps a lot of guys in line. By the way, your pay was raised this morning. You get a buck and a half.
And you get a half.
Roughly. And you're a number one man now. You're not a helper anymore.
Well, gee, thanks.
That's all right. You're a nice kid. I like the way you get along down here.
You know, Tommy told me that there were 73 unsolved murders in his piers in the last 10 years.
That many?
Yeah, that's
really
what Tommy said. He said that maybe some of those guys that were killed were on his side. See, Tommy was on my side.
Well, good for Tommy. And good for you.
Yeah. Well, I just want to let you know, Mr. Mills. Tommy isn't going to be number 74.
Charlie.
Well, what do you want?
I'm taking you down to the cops, Charlie.
You're crazy.
Yeah. I may be crazy, Charlie, but I'm taking you down to the cops.
Yeah? Put you in a pen.
Maybe. Anyway, you're coming. Throw away that hook, Charlie. This is going to be my way, Charlie. You know, actually, this isn't even fair. Because you're about this big.
Thank you.
better take a look at that guy. I think he fell down. Well, operator, give me the police.
You're crazy. You'll go to the pen.
Can't hurt a guy who's 10 feet tall.
You're crazy.
Officer, my name is Axel Norton. N-O-R-D.